back here in the studios, and I'm joined by Michelle W. Book. You are a holistic nutritionist. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
They say you learn something every day, and what I learned is that next week we've got a special week, right? What is next week?
It's Natural Health Products Week. And so at the Canadian Health Food Association, we conducted a national survey and found that 91% of Canadians say that their health is significantly impacts their level of happiness.
But that's so true, right? Because if you go through a spell, like, you know, I went through like 2 months where I was just like feeling under the weather, and it drains you of energy. It doesn't make you feel positive. It gets you a little depressed. And we want to sort of get out of that funk, especially in the fall, right? Because this is the time of year. This is the time of year where there's bugs going around and things can get pretty bad pretty quickly.
It's definitely cold and flu season. And so we identified the four pillars for, you know, keeping us healthy and
happy.
This
is what we're looking at here. We are seeing four pillars right in front of you, right?
Yes.
And the first one is really nutrition, right?
It is. It is. Because we know that without proper nutrition, we're not going to have, you know, optimal immune function. So nutrition is really important. Vitamin C in particular.
Okay.
Interestingly, in our study, 46% of Canadians said that they use vitamin C when they're not feeling well.
And where, you know, I think obviously you got the orange right there. That's what I think. You think of vitamin C, orange, but there's other places you can get your vitamin C, right?
And that's what a lot of people do. But especially, you know, this time of year, there's lots of great veggies. Kale, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, all high in vitamin C.
Putting kale in a smoothie, good idea for this time of year.
Excellent idea this time of year.
You do have some other stuff on the table. For me, I'm just going to go right to it because I'm Greek and I love garlic. You got garlic here. Tell me why I'm so smart, because I put garlic in everything.
That you are very, very smart. Garlic actually helps to boost the immune system.
Okay.
So it's going to help with that white blood cell production, which we know is really important for the immune system. Reishi mushrooms as well, and nuts. All immune-boosting foods that we want to incorporate into our diet this time of year.
And nuts, right? They regulate a lot of things in the body, don't they?
They do. They have a really significant impact. And we know they have protein, they have zinc, selenium. So all really important nutrients to help, again, boost that immune system.
And the other thing that I probably could do a better job at... I exercise every day in the fact that I walk my dog an hour a day. I'm walking for an hour.
That's perfect.
You know, let's talk about exercise, because that is another key pillar, right?
It's very, very important. And, you know, 30 to 60 minutes of exercise a day, you know, even a brisk walk really does make a difference.
Does it really?
Yes.
Like, I'm doing an okay job here if I'm doing that walk?
You really are, because it's going to help to, you know, improve circulation.
Yeah.
It's going to help to get the bacteria flushed through those airways and lungs. And also it's going to reduce stress. So it plays a really important role. And we know that krill oil and vitamin D also with, you know, incorporated really are important.
Can you talk to me just a bit? You mentioned krill oil.
Yes.
I hear this. I've heard about krill oil before. But why is that just such a key thing to put into your diet?
Krill oil really is because it's high in omega-3s.
Okay.
And we know we need those omega-3s, especially when it comes to, you know, this time of year. That really omega-3s do play an important role in our immune health. Vitamin D as well. A lot of people don't realize how important vitamin D is. This time of year, we're just simply not getting enough vitamin D.
And I think some people get turned off from exercise because of, the equipment and that kind of stuff. But look at these things over here. That's not a burden, right? Anyone can pick up these, you know, the dumbbells, right? Is that a 5 pound, right?
Yeah, it's so easy. It's so easy to just get a little bit more exercise. And, you know, it's also really important to get more sleep. Sleep this time of year especially is so
important. Well, I can definitely sleep on something as soft as this, right?
Definitely. But sleep, you know, between 7 and 8 hours is really going to help the immune system. We want to make sure that, you know, if we're struggling with sleep, we can look to magnesium.
You mentioned sleep.
Yes.
So last night, World Series.
Yes.
I had to watch it. Went to bed at 1, got up at 4. That's 3 hours of sleep. Long term, what kind of damage can you do if you're not getting those 7 to 8 hours?
Well, it's definitely going to have a huge impact on your immune system. And, you know, when bugs or bacteria attack or, you know, you come in contact with, your body is not going to be able to identify and fight off those invading bugs. So we really want to make sure we're getting enough sleep. And we also want to make sure that we're, you know, practicing mindfulness.
Mm-hmm.
We're hearing more and more about the importance of mindfulness.
Okay, but you have to explain that to me, because I hear mindfulness.
Yes.
And I'm like, well, there's mind and there's... I what does that mean?
And, you know, I get that question a lot. Mindfulness is about really connecting in, being present, taking a couple deep breaths, meditation, even 5 to 10 minutes to help reduce those stress levels is really going to help, again, with your overall health.
Okay, so I have a question for you, because I have an Apple Watch.
Yes.
And they just added a breathe thing. So throughout the day, it pops on me and it pops up and it says breathe. And it leads you through an exercise. It's very short. But that can have an impact.
That is so perfect to be doing that. People don't realize, you know, the impact we get in that monkey mind brain, and we're go, go, go. taking the time to relax, you know, reset is really going to help our overall health and ultimately our happiness. And, you know, on our website, chfa.ca, yeah, we have all kinds of great tips on how to be more mindful, how to get more sleep, how to incorporate these natural health products into your day-to-day lifestyle, which is really important.
Michelle W. Book, thank you so much for joining us. That's awesome. And for next week, you want to get involved in this, just go to your local natural health food store. Is that
exactly
what you'd say?
Exactly. And you can find that on our website, chfa.ca. All kinds of great information. It's a great celebration.
Awesome. Thanks, Michelle. All right. Thank
stay
you. Healthy, everyone out there. When we